Hello, welcome. In today's video, we're going to test lossless scaling on RPC S3. Can this tool handle Sony exclusives even when running on a 2020 CPU? Stick around until the end of the video, where we'll test various games, compare the results with and without the application, and discuss whether it's worth using LS for each game individually. But before anything else, make sure to leave a like so this video can reach even more people and help our channel grow on the platform. And if this is your first time here, consider subscribing for new content every week. Before we start, let's talk about the setup used. I'm using the 2.11 beta version and decided to use the X3 preset, which allows us to triple our FPS while requiring the game to run at only 30 FPS to achieve good results. If I had chosen the X4 preset, the minimum FPS would have had to be 60 FPS, which would already make things a bit more complicated. Keep in mind that the maximum FPS that can be displayed is my current refresh rate, which is 180 FPS, the maximum supported by my monitor. The entire preset configuration used should be appearing on the screen now, and if you want to know how to configure or use LS, I'll leave the playlist in the card and in the description. To start, I chose a game that doesn't present major problems, which is Drakengard 3. As you can see, in this specific game, my FPS is over 100 at this point. So, you might be wondering, why did I record this game then? Because since the game can't run at the maximum refresh rate of my monitor, I can use LS to keep it, for the most part, as close to the maximum as possible. And as you can see, since the FPS displayed before interpolation is higher than 30, our results are excellent, with virtually no visual defects.
If we want the good encoders to live, then the traitorous one must die!
Shut up with the bullshit already, would you?
Now, let's move on to a much more difficult game to emulate, which is God of War Ascension. The situation here is more complicated, with the game running below 30 FPS, even in closed areas. This would still be enough to use LS without issues, but at other times, especially with large enemies on screen, the FPS can drop to near 20 and make things quite complicated. By enabling LS, I was able to maintain 30 FPS even in open areas, and the generated FPS went above 90. Making the experience very smooth. However, things can get a bit worse, bringing the game back to just over 20 FPS. The generated result up to this point was over 80 FPS output, and at that moment, I felt the gameplay was quite smooth and could indeed be considered playable. But as the input FPS was below 30 FPS, I admit I felt some input delay. Later in the video, we'll talk directly about input delay. In conclusion, it is indeed possible to play God of War Ascension with LS. But the delay will increase slightly, which might cause some discomfort. God of War 3 is the game most people are waiting to become playable. However, even after years of RPC S3 development, there's still no decent way to play it unless you have a top-of-the-line processor. In my case, I can play with variable FPS that sometimes reaches over 60, while at other times, it's a bit over 20. Honestly, in this case, I'd rather wait for the game to receive more optimizations. In the footage I recorded, the game was varying between 24 and 40 FPS, which I already consider playable. However, when enabling LS, the gameplay jumped to over 120 FPS, making everything much more enjoyable. There were no graphical artifacts or other major issues, but be aware that if the FPS drops below 30 due to the compilation of a new shader, for example, artifacts may appear. The activation of LS did not generate significant input delay, and it was even possible to execute the QuickTime events without any difficulty. For me, God of War 3 is much better with LS. If I were to play this game right now, I would definitely use LS because I see only benefits. Gran Turismo 5 also has acceptable gameplay on my PC, even varying between 40 and 60 FPS in some environments. So much so that, at this point, I already have over 20 hours of gameplay. However, playing a racing game at around 40 FPS still causes some visual discomfort. When enabling LS, we now reach around 150 to 180 FPS, much better. However, I did feel a bit more input delay here. In fact, I made some mistakes while driving with LS enabled that I didn't make without it. So, my advice is, if you want to try out faster games like Gran Turismo 5, see if the input delay works for you. I know that, over time, our brains adjust, and these things become less noticeable, bothering us less. If the input delay doesn't bother you or you're already used to it, I recommend using LS. And we always make things even more complicated, so let's move on to Gran Turismo 6. It seems that every time I test this game, it's in a worse state. In the new updates, I can barely maintain 20 FPS, and the sky is flickering in a way that bothers me and can be unplayable for someone with epilepsy. In the past, I was able to run this game between 28 and 30 FPS on this same track. We know that enabling LS under these conditions would bring horrible results, full of graphical problems both in the HUD and in other moving objects, but let's do it anyway. As expected, enabling it caused major artifacts and objects closer to the edge of the screen, and once again, there was a significant increase in input delay, causing me to spin the car at the very beginning. Again, I hadn't lost control during the first laps where LS was disabled. In games like Gran Turismo 6, there is no magic, either you have a great processor, or you won't be able to run the game. LS here won't help you, on the contrary, it will generate unwanted input delay that will further disrupt your experience. Another very serious case is Infamous 2. This is another game that demands a high-end processor to run decently. Even in the initial areas, I couldn't get close to 30 FPS, making the game unplayable this way. When enabling LS, we now managed to exceed 60 FPS, and the smoothness is something enjoyable. However, I had never seen a game with so many graphical artifacts before, and the input delay also became very bad, making the experience completely broken. The game that was already unplayable remains unplayable, only now with various errors. At another moment, in a calmer environment, we can see how horrible the displayed artifacts are. I also tested the first Infamous, which simply refused to open in this version of the emulator, crashing right after the Sony screen, even following all the RPCS3 configuration recommendations. Uncharted 1 and 2 also didn't run properly, crashing at the start screen. Maybe it's because this version was downloaded from the PSN, but I had tested these games before on other versions, and although the FPS was bad, they ran normally. In fact, I already considered the first Infamous playable because, despite the problems, it had a decent frame rate. Lastly, I ran an input delay test, capturing the screen directly with my phone. Even in Infamous 2, which has low FPS and with the controller connected via Bluetooth, the delay is almost zero, with the character jumping almost instantly when pressing the button. However, when enabling LS, it's noticeable that the jumps are executed with a few milliseconds of delay. I sincerely believe that when playing this type of game in story mode and not in competitive games, the issues caused by LS due to input delay would be a good trade-off, especially when compared to games like God of War 3, where there was a significant FPS boost. To conclude, LS can indeed save your games in RPCS3, especially in the God of War franchise. Obviously, your PC needs to be able to run the game at least 30 FPS, otherwise, there will be several other problems. This method will help you, but it doesn't perform miracles, it causes input delay, which, depending on the game, may cause more problems than the low FPS itself. Keep in mind that RPCS3 uses your CPU to its fullest extent, but regarding GPU usage, the requirements are much lower. Therefore, the boost provided by LS doesn't impact the FPS in RPCS3 unless your GPU is already maxed out with this emulator. Even so, the ideal situation would be for the emulator to receive the necessary fixes so that these games become playable, which has not happened so far. And that's the video. I hope it was helpful to you. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.